Hey guys, I'm going to do something a little different today and talk about a topic that I get a lot of questions on. And that's how you can make some money with your martial arts training. I've been asked this question by a lot of people, and I've even seen a lot of forums where people ask how they can do it. And the responses are usually, well, you got to open up a big school or you need to fight to make some money with your training. And the reality is, if you're just looking to make some nice extra part-time money, you don't have to open up a big school. And there's a lot of risk involved in a big school. And you might be able to make some money fighting, but there's a good chance you get injured, and that's really not for a lot of people. So let me tell you about what I've done over the last 40 years to make some money when I wasn't running a full-time school. And if you apply this, you should be able to do the same thing yourself if you want to. So first, operating a martial arts school really is not about teaching martial arts or teaching MMA. It's about running a business. I've known a lot of people who have the dream of opening up their own school, and once they actually do it, it becomes a nightmare for them. It's really not what they were expecting. So what's really involved in opening up a successful brick and mortar school? You got startup costs. You got a lot of tasks that are involved to open up. You got a lot of risk. Here, let me show you some of the things right here. Okay, for example, you're writing business plans. You have to find startup capital, leasing, research, equipment, everything you need. You have to have working or ongoing capital to pay your rent and utilities and advertising until you're making a profit, if you make a profit. You have to do demographic studies to make sure there's enough people there. You have to find a good location. You know, is there too many competitors nearby? Do you have drive-by traffic? Is there foot traffic? There's a lot of stuff, guys. You got to pay your rent and utilities. You have to develop a staff because you're going to need help. You have to implement student tracking and retention systems. You know, keep up with supplies for the school. You have online advertising and you have offline advertising. You got to be doing demonstrations and things. So you have to do all that before you even begin to think about teaching. See what I'm getting at here? That's a huge job and you may end up enjoying it, but if you're just looking to make some part-time money, there's some easier ways. So what I would recommend to you is to use other people's business locations and other people's resources. Get this, every time that I've done that, I've immediately made money from my very first class. I never lost a penny or incurred any debt, and I got to teach exactly what I wanted rather than teaching, you know, junior dragons classes and kids stuff, and I had a great time doing it. So when I did that, I basically got to live the dream that these other guys always wanted to do, but they got too wrapped up in running the business, okay? So pay attention to what I'm going to tell you here. So here's why it's easier to use other people's businesses and their resources. And I'll tell you how to go about that shortly. First of all, there's plenty of it available. Okay, there's plenty of locations that you can use if you know where to look. It's a win-win situation for you and the business owner. And the business owner gets to make extra money and they have to do very little work. Okay, they've already done the work. So there's a space that they wouldn't be using anyways. So they're just gonna be making money from it. The benefits to you are huge. First, you don't have to do any of the major biz startup work that I talked about before. Okay, that stuff it's a really big job starting the business. You get immediate income without any upfront costs or stress. There's no time-consuming job of maintaining and promoting the business on a daily basis. You basically get to walk in and just teach classes and go home. I mean, that's a pretty sweet deal for you. The business owner assumes the risk, pretty much all the risk, and you pretty much profit right from the start, okay? So that's a huge benefit for you. Some other things that really work in your favor is the business owner's insurance may already cover you. Often, this is probably the biggest benefit here that I'll explain later. The business has built-in students for you in many cases. Okay, that's huge. Just trying to get students is a tough job. Opening a school is easy. Filling the school is difficult. So if you decide to open your own school later too, now that you have students, these students will follow you and you'll be off to a much better start. So again, it's a win-win situation for both people, but usually it ends up being a much better deal for you. Okay, so how do you get this type of situation? Where do you find the locations to teach? My favorite is, and this one I'm going to emphasize, my favorite one is a dance school. Okay, sounds a little strange. Why would you want to do martial arts at a dance school? There's a lot of reasons. Okay, first, it's going to have pretty much all the benefits that I described above, including the built-in students. And I'll tell you about that shortly. It's a proven location, okay? The demographics are already done. If this school has been in existence for any period of time, you already know that there's people who are willing to drive to that location. Parents are going to be coming, bringing kids. There's, you know, there's parents there. There's guys or fathers. There's going to be children. Everything you need, okay? It's already proven. There's plenty of these dance schools available, and you're going to use them when they'd otherwise be closed. And these schools, they have nice big open rooms with mirrors. They have stretching bars for people to stretch with. Dance schools have gymnastic classes, so a lot of times they're already have mats for you. Otherwise, if you have your own mats, you bring them in, and the dance school owner is going to love you if you say, hey, you guys can use my mats for your classes. Okay, so it's a win-win situation for both people. Also, these dance schools just aren't as intimidating as an MMA gym for a lot of people. Okay, so you might find that to be a real benefit for you. Now, here's what I consider to be the biggest benefit of using the dance school and some of the other locations that I'll tell you about. Dancers are mostly young girls, right? And these young girls have brothers. So you already know that the parents are willing to take the girls to the dance classes. They're exactly the type they're going to take their son in for martial arts training, for MMA training with you. You basically just have to let them know it's available. So not just only do they have brothers, but they also these girls also have fathers. And these fathers are young enough to train, but they're old enough to need something to keep them in shape, and you've got what they need. And a lot of cases, the mothers are looking for something to keep them in shape too. The other benefits of using a dance school is that you get the built-in trust and reputation and familiarity that these schools have already generated. All right, you're going to inherit the goodwill that the school has already built with all these people in the community. And the brothers and the fathers and mothers, they're already familiar with the school. So it's not like you're trying to convince them to go into something they haven't, that they don't feel comfortable with. Okay, they're familiar with it. They just have to show up now. Get it? So the biggest thing you want to do, the most important thing, is you want to position your class as part of the school's curriculum. Rather than saying, hey, business owner, can I rent your school from you when you're not using it? You want to talk to them about offering it as another one of the programs at their school. Okay, the reason you want to do that is, first of all, now that you're just a part of their curriculum, now you can have the front desk collect the money for you, which it takes that job out of your hands. It just frees you up to teach. It gives you the school's stamp of approval that they've maybe spent years on building the reputation. You have built-in registration and bookkeeping, right? The front desk person just signs everybody up. You don't have to do any of that, and they'll collect the money for you. It's easy. You want to split with the school owner. You want to split by percentage, not a flat fee. Don't say, I'll pay you, $100 a week or whatever. Say, let's split how much we take in. The reason you want to do that is because it gives the owner motivation to promote your classes to the kids' parents and to everybody in the community with all their marketing they're already doing. Okay, so now that they're going to get a percentage, so now they'll want to put a sign up in the lobby. They're going to put flyers on the front desk. They're doing all this free advertising for you. And again, the owner's already advertising, maybe in the local papers. All they have to do is just add into what they're advertising, just say MMA classes available. All right. And suddenly you're getting more students than you can handle. I know because I've done this before. It works wonderfully. You can also offer demonstrations right at the school. You just put up a sign in the school and you're getting all these children, these parents and these fathers bringing their daughters in too. Who've got sons, they want their sons to do something. You say, hey, Saturday morning, I'm going to be doing a demonstration, all right? You're going to have people at your demonstration, and a lot of the fathers are going to want to show up too. And something I did that worked really well is you just show up even when you're not teaching classes. And again, the lobby is going to be filled with parents waiting for the kids. You just hang out to them, talk to them, make friends with them, tell them about your class, all right? You're going to get people to sign up. It's one of the easiest ways you can get students. All right, so that's just a huge, huge benefit for you over trying to do something on your own. One of the other things here too that you don't want to overlook is that the school owner is already providing for doing cleaning. They're doing maintenance on the building. They're getting the bathroom supplies, insurance in some cases that may cover you, paying electricity, water, sewer. They're already throwing their holiday parties, right? Your students are part of that group now. So basically, you just have to walk in and teach. They get to go to the parties. Everything is done for you. It makes it teaching much easier, much nicer, and more enjoyable than if you're having to do all those things yourself. So that would be my number one recommendation. The rest of the recommendations are going to have some benefits like that. I'm just going to run through them real quick. But the dance school has all those benefits if you do it right. So other locations could be like YMCAs. Again, YMCAs, they have a lobby. They have people coming through so they can do advertising for you. You got community rec centers. They're going to be similar. Teen centers. And you got parks with after school programs. Okay, so they will have some of the benefits that I mentioned before that are involved with the dance school. The dance school, in my opinion, seem to have the most. Otherwise, if you won't get the same benefits, but just if you want to find locations, empty space that's not being used, you can try yoga centers. I've taught there. Fitness centers inside of gated communities and apartment complexes. Okay, a lot of these communities have a fitness room, and this they wouldn't mind if they had somebody coming and teaching a class once in a while. You got colleges, you got senior centers. You may not want to teach the seniors, but you can use the space there, because sometimes these senior centers are wanting extra money, or just simply parks and beaches, which a lot of times you can just use for free. Okay, so those last ones don't have the same benefits, but it might give you a location. But go with the ones that I suggested. If your goal is just to try to make some extra cash, it's a pretty easy thing to do, very low risk, and as I said, you pretty much make money from day one. Okay, hope that helped you out.